kind of learn to hold their weight. Okay, so the hips are going to be level. Keeping the knee up, always say, play on your knee, that way you can eat your dinner if you're hungry. Right? So everything goes through here. For the heel stretch, if your kids are having trouble, you can actually come in and grab them. Make sure you put them up, hands on, a lot of body movement. You put them where you want them to be, their muscle memory will eventually take over, and then that way will help. So just telling them, hey, roll your ankle under, hey, get your hubby there. That doesn't mean much. Actually physically grab them, put them under there. So you got that? And so if they have trouble with the flexibility, just push them into position. So when they're at best, I'll put my hands under the rib cage and grab by the knee again, making sure that I'm not pushing hard on pressure points. And a lot of times, drop the chest. They'll kind of lean over, try to make it really high. That's great. Pretty, but balance is not so awesome. So you're going to emphasize pulling up here, extending out the back. Remember the scorpion, often they're not going to be really flexible at first. Scorpions are about back flexibility, okay? Yes, you want to be flexible through here, but it really is about your back. So then you, if they need help, I grab it, pull it up. Again, pushing on the rib cage. Okay, it's a safe place to support and scale. You know, drop that. There you go. So for most normal people, so they're going to hit a Y. Again, so everything, if I can draw this kind of like little box, everything stays in between there. She's not moving and leaning over. She's not leaning in the back. Everything's staying nice and centered, so her weight is on top of the base of things. Do you want me to see those again? Video